Each component can have inputs, outputs, properties and actions. Click on an input pin to select its properties. The input name cannot be changed. It is compiled with the component. The subsampling downsamples the input directly. When putting two, you will get only one sample out of two. In the Type Filter tab, you can see all compatible data types that this input can accept. You can also select multiple inputs at the same time. Different property values across the selected inputs are highlighted in red. It's a very useful feature when inspecting diagrams. Click on an output pin to select its properties. Subsampling works exactly the same as for the inputs. It divides the output frequency by this factor. FIFO size is the size of the output circular buffer in number of samples. This can be changed here. In the Type tab, you can see the data type that is emitted with this output, as well as additional flags description. Let's have a brief look at the bypass component. If we look at the input types that the bypass accepts, we see all RTMaps types. Same for the output types. Now let's look at the properties. Properties can hold different types: checkbox, drop-down menu, text entry, time, integer or float. Port is here a text entry. Baud rate is an enum, which translates to a drop-down menu. Same for stop bits. Minimum exposes an integer value. Use request to send is a boolean, which translates into a checkbox. Time is also a special subtype that has its own display. Now let's have a look at actions. Actions are triggered via a right click on the component. Here we can scan for COM ports on Windows. Help is also available for every component as an action. In the Help, you will find details about inputs, outputs, properties and actions, as well as a general description. Let's load the GPS package to finish our diagram. To connect components, use the connection mode. Use the mouse middle click to set and unset this mode. Add a devectorizer component to extract the longitude and latitude from the LLA position output. The vector size property should be set to 3 if we want to get the elevation as well. Let's add a data viewer to read and set its number of inputs to 3. Now, we will perform a cluster connection. This will connect all compatible inputs and outputs together. Select the first component, press and hold the Alt key on your keyboard, and then click on the second component. And that's done.